Hi everyone, welcome to HowFixit. In this video guide, I will show you how to replace the internal M2 SSD in your Xbox Series S. To disassemble your Xbox Series S, you will need the following tools. Torx T8 and Torx T10 screwdrivers. Plastic pry tools and anti-static tweezers. I also recommend using a magnetic mat and laying out each screw step by step during the disassembly process. Throughout this repair, keep track of each screw and make sure it goes back exactly where it came from to avoid damaging your Xbox. Thanks to the magnetic base, the screws stay on the mat and you will not lose them. In the description, I left links where you can buy all the necessary repair tools. Also, in the description, you can find a link to a video where I show you how to restore a water-damaged Xbox Series S controller. I hope with your controller everything is okay, but if that happens, you will know what to do in that case. Let's start disassembling the Xbox Series S. Remove the two white covers located on the bottom corners of the game console housing. Remove two screws with a Torx T8 screwdriver. Use a Torx T10 screwdriver to remove the next 7 screws. Push apart the two corners of the plastic case and slide the chassis towards you. Now you can lift up the chassis. Remove the next 9 screws. Turn the console and lift up the cover. Now you get access to the fan and power supply. To disconnect the power supply, just lift it up from the motherboard and disconnect the 4-pin connector from the motherboard. Remove 3 screws and disconnect the Bluetooth panel. To disconnect the Bluetooth panel from the chassis, just pull it towards you. Remove the screw and disconnect the board with the power button. Remove 3 screws and disconnect the panel with the Wi-Fi module. Turn the case over and remove the 4 screws. Grasp the heatsink with your fingers and lift up the front of the motherboard. The Xbox Series S game console has a 2230 size M2 NVMe SSD with PCIe 4th generation. Replacing the M2 SSD, you need to clone the software from the old drive to the new one. If you don't transfer the software, the M2 SSD will not work on your Xbox Series S. For how to clone the software, watch my other video instruction. I left a link in the description. It is also worth noting that not every M2 SSD will run on an Xbox Series S, even if the drive specs match the requirements of a gaming console. The number of supported M2 SSDs will be expanded. When I created this video, the game console worked only with M2 SSDs taken from the same Xbox Series S donor. In the description, I will leave links to compatible M2 drives as they become available. If you have any experience replacing an M2 SSD drive in the Xbox Series S, whether it is a successful experience or not, share in the comments which M2 SSD did you use to replace. It will help others choose the right SSD drive. Thank you. now the Xbox Series S is assembled and ready to use. I really appreciate you watching my video guide. If you have any questions, please leave them below. You are on HowFixit, and see you guys next time.